Hey everyone, this is David Brown from Lyco Birds, and as we start the fall hawk watching season, some of the volunteers at the hawk watch I work at have been asking about how to identify broad-winged hawks versus red-shouldered hawks versus red-tailed hawks, especially for juveniles. So I thought I would put together a quick video to cover the identification of these three species. So let's begin with a broad-winged hawk. Broadwings are the smallest of the three, and I like to think of them as small and chunky. And often they migrate in big groups, so we can get used to identifying them that way. But what if we just have a single individual bird? What are we looking at? First of all, I think the wingtip is something important to look at. The wingtip of broadwings is more pointed looking than the other species because the wingtip only has four feathers. 1, 2, 3, 4. On the other wing, 1, 2, 3, 4. So the wingtip looks pointed, especially compared to red-shouldered hawk, which we'll look at in a second. We also notice that there's no dark patagial bars like we would see on a red tail. And there's also no belly band like we would see on a red tail. Overall, on juvenile broadwings and red shoulders, this whole area of the underside of the body and the tail looks very similar. So if we're pretty sure that it's not a red tail and that it's one of the other two, we're often looking at the wingtips. So again, for broadwings, you want to look for that pointed wingtip. Let's switch now to red-shouldered hawk, and let's look at the wingtip. Now we don't have a pointed wingtip. We have a very squared off or rounded wingtip because there's five feathers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We also see translucent crescents or commas near the wingtips. And this is a field mark that's visible from an incredible distance when the bird's high overhead. So that's one of the best ways to differentiate it from the other two species. But again, if we look at the underside markings, the body and the tail looks very similar to what we see on juvenile broad-winged hawks. So it's not too helpful. Again, we don't see the belly band like a red tail would have, and we don't have dark patagial bars. So we're mainly looking at that wingtip. Another thing we can look at on red-shouldered hawks is the tail often looks longer than it does on the other two species. And their behavior is actually more similar to an occipiter like a Cooper's hawk, in the sense that red-shouldered hawks tend to flap more than the other Buteos. So when a red-shouldered hawk is soaring, you might see it flapping occasionally. When it breaks into a glide, you might see it flap. You keep watching it, 10 seconds later, it flaps again. It's a behavior you don't see too much on the other Buteos. Let's take a look at the red-tailed hawk now. The red tail is the largest of the three. And to me, it just comes across as a bigger, more powerful bird. Especially if you've been seeing a lot of broad-winged hawks that day and a red tail flies over. Just in the time that it takes it to soar, the way that it flaps, it just comes across as a more powerful bird. If we look at some of the field marks, we see it has dark patagial bars in the shoulder area. We have the belly band. That's a classic field mark for the red-tailed hawk. We don't have the namesake tail on the juveniles. So the shape looks pretty similar to a red-shouldered hawk, but maybe the wingtip looks slightly more rounded rather than that squared-off look, and we don't see any translucent crescents. Now, we do see translucent squares on these inner primaries on both wings, especially when you have the bird directly overhead and maybe the sun shining through it. You have the light shining through squares, but you don't get those crescents that the red shoulders have. So one more look at them. Broad-winged hawks are small with pointed wingtips. Their small size means they circle more quickly than the other species, often migrate in large groups called kettles. Red-shouldered hawks, we're looking at that squared off wingtip with translucent crescents and a longer tail. Red-tailed hawk, just that classic shape, big, powerful bird, no translucent crescents. but we do have a belly band and patagial bars. So that's a basic summary of how to identify these species. You can check out some of my other videos for more details about these species and how to identify them in different postures and different ages. But that's a basic summary of how to tell apart these juvenile Buteos. So hopefully you can use this information to be able to better identify hawks this fall. This is David Brown. Thanks for watching.